Hey DIY crafters, I'm in the studio today and I'm going to share with you how to create a keepsake pillow for that very special person in your life. And I'd like to encourage you to please stay tuned to the end of the show because I'm going to share a very special tip on how to make this two gifts in one. First though, of course we need to get started and I'm going to be using my favorite upcycle material and that's cardboard as one of the bases for our project. We're also going to be using dyes from the Spellbinders Media Mixage line. And here you can see that I have my Hearts 1 die template set. This is the number 3 and the number 2 with 1 being the smallest. I have them on my cutting plate with my cardboard, my dies cutting side down. You'll complete this sandwich with the base plate and you'll pass this through the Artisan Explorer machine to cut it out. While you're cutting things out, you'll also want to cut a couple of shapes out of fabric. And again, I'm using the Media Mixage line. I'm using the number 2 from the Hearts 1 die, and I've just cut it out of a plain piece of muslin. I've also have just a pretty pink pattern fabric here that I've cut using the largest circle in either the dot or the circles 1 or the circles 3 die templates set. I have 3 different patterns of fabric along with some lace, and these are just scraps that I have left over from other projects. And so you'll want to choose the base fabric for your heart, and for this project I'm going to choose this really pretty, very spring green gingham. I have painted the base of my cardboard a light gray. You can use a light white, a light gray, off-white, whatever color works for you. And this is because my fabric tends to be a little lightweight and the cardboard color would actually show through. I also have applied some tacky glue to the top of my cardboard shape. I like to get my fingers dirty. I'm just going to spread this around, and the reason I'm doing this is because I'm going to add a little bit of polyfill, a little stuffing to the top, just to give it a nice quilted look. Now the reason I'm using the cardboard as a base is because it's lightweight and you can sew through it if you need to. And then you're going to sandwich your shape in between your two layers of your fabric. I'm using the cardboard as my guide and I'm just taking a little running stitch all the way around this heart. I'm going to use my scissors to cut a border all the way around my heart. I've also added some fabric flowers and I'm going to show you how to make those with these little circles that we cut out just a little bit ago. So what I'm doing is I'm just taking my fabric scissors and I'm going to cut a spiral. Okay, now starting with the point right here, we're going to just roll that towards the center. Take a little stitch through all of the layers. Open it up, and at this point you're going to just make as many flowers as you want. Before I collage all my layers together, I'm going to add this little heart on top of my heart base. I'm just going to stitch around the edges again. And if you take a look at my finished heart, you'll see my fabric flowers there alongside some vintage buttons. I've accented the base with some lace. I made the pillow from 2 rectangles of fabric stitched along the outer edges. And for an extra special touch, I used an ink pad and a rubber stamp to stamp my sentiment directly onto the muslin fabric. And that tip that I promised, well, here it is. So instead of attaching your heart directly to your pillow, attach it by putting it on a pin back. And that way it can be worn as a brooch or corsage, or it can be displayed on this beautiful keepsake pillow for years to come. Now please make sure you take a moment to subscribe to my videos. You can do that by clicking that link in that upper corner right up there and take a moment to click the like button. I'm Linda Peterson. Thanks for joining me in my studio today and on my DIY channel. And keep living a creative life.